So now let's talk about the loop lighting pattern. In the earlier lesson in this video, we saw when I was doing views of the face, I really tried to keep a loop lighting pattern on all of those different views of the face. So we might be repeating here a bit, but at least it's in sequence with our butterfly to our loop lighting pattern. We achieve a loop lighting pattern by keeping the axis of the subject's face. I'm going to let Toby continue to look straight into camera, but I'm going to let Aaron just move that light around just a bit. And when we talked about our off-camera flash training video, we talked about how far around she needed to move that light. She's going to move around the subject to the far side of the nose, just disappears, but you can still see plenty of the far side of the cheek. Refer to the other training videos. You got all that stuff in depth in those training videos. So having said that, let's go back now to what we're doing right here. Just right there. Take it a little bit higher for me, Aaron, just about 10 inches above. And let's see, drop your left shoulder down for me, Toby, a little bit. Bring your head a little tilt. Chin down a little bit more, right there, perfect. So check my lighting, Aaron. Are we good for loop? Okay, great. Here we go. And now you can see the loop lighting pattern, very, very beautiful on her face. Again, let me reemphasize that I'm running these at a fairly high contrast lighting ratio. What do we mean by contrast lighting ratio? When you look at the image up on the screen, you'll see the highlight density quite bright. You'll see the shadow density is quite dark. The ratio of the highlight to the shadows is called the contrast lighting ratio. In portrait studios, we tend to work at about a 3-to-1 ratio, which is about a 1 and a 1/2 f-stop difference between the highlights to the shadows. I'm a guy who likes a 3-to-1, and I like to scoot a little bit towards a 4-to-1, which would be a 2-f-stop difference from the highlight to the shadow. That means that if I would meter the highlight side of my bride's face, I might be metering f8. If I meter the shadow side, I would be metering it at about f4. So if I'm somewhere around 4, 4.5, that's between a 3-to-1, 4-to-1 ratio, I think that looks fine. I think we're probably looking at the images right now up on screen that are probably closer to a 5-to-1, maybe a 6-to-1. We're not going to meter. I think it's beyond the scope of these lessons right here. But I wanted you to be aware that this more contrasting lighting is simply to show the lighting patterns on the face. So that's why we're doing it. I'm going to continue through it as we move through our other lighting patterns.